Identification. The spell fails. Staff of Might, melee weapon. Oh. So funny, you see black wizard and the other's a spell right. Okay. Damage 12, shield 2. Only usable by the wizards. Scale, oh! Use magic goes up by 20. And gray magic, I wonder if a non-gray wizard can use this. X-ray vision? That's a new spell to me. So I think I'm gonna take that. I meaning Amethyst. Because that will increase my spell. My use magic, which I need. That's sweet. I'm pretty sure we need to be wielding it, don't we? Use magic 47. Look at that. Be cool if they put this in green to show you that it's especially, it's a special, you know, what do you call it? Enhanced. 57, 53, 76. We're gonna be casting spells is gonna be pretty much easier now. So I'm happy about that. Oh, it also boosted our spell points. Alright. I say we camp outside and save a little bit of money. I just want to increase the spell levels. The mana levels of Sateen and Amethyst. Everyone else is fine. I'm glad we don't need to heal any deleterious effects or anything like that. So where am I? We need to make our way back. The Guild of Warriors. I can camp out here. Let's see what we do. Nationals. Needs to be eating. That sounds sad. Rations 8. Oh, he's only got one. Okay, so everyone has 0 except for her. About to take care of his. guess she's full now. Guess I thought it worked and it didn't. Oh. Am I not paying attention, or am I just missing these people? Okay, so these will be at zero. This is the trick, how you save rations. We only need these two to get there. Spell points back. I wish you could automatically hit Z and just go again instead of going out. Or rest until healed option or something like that. Evidently I'm full now, so... The only problem is... She can carry all those rations. 87. Cause she can't identify on something else. Either way, I wanna get her up to 4. We wanna identify this. Identification, we can try once. Girdle of Thievery? Something like that? Girdle of Thieves. Okay, shield 9. Only used by Thief, not surprisingly. Okay, increases dexterity by 10 and find traps by 10. And gives you clairvoyance 3, 8 charges. Awesome. Find traps. Oh, it's too bad it's not pick locks, right? Alright, well this will help. Definitely. Alright, so we will give that to Silk, of course. I guess it'll go here? Instead of that, studded leather. Yeah, because I don't see a belt slot. Shield 6 for studded leather. And this is like 9, I think. So that's fine. Was 12, now 15, and he's got these increases. So find traps is now 30%. And what else? Yeah. You can cast a spell. Dexterity has actually increased by 10 as well. What's his dex? 70. Oh, see, you can go over the max. His max is 60. But his current dexterity is 70. That's freaking awesome. That's awesome. I gotta rest more. I don't know how much we can give her, as far as food. I don't really have an option to give somebody food and not have them use it. Not have them use it, because she can't... Unless I just... Probably gonna do that. Is she holding anything heavy? Let's see. Oh yeah, she's holding this sword, so just give this sword to somebody else. And then she might be able to hold all these rations. Two-hander. one can hold it. You know? So how many can we hold? I mean, that item. It's only her that needs to be... Okay, good. So now I can just rest with impunity. Only she will be using rations. So we can just... With it. What am I doing? So I'm trying to do things quick because this is annoying this way. I want to get up to full anyway, so might as well just get her up to full and then. Then we'll identify something. It's gotta be a better way, man. I want to click the horse again. Don't click the horse. I wonder if you can sell that clock. What else am I going to do with it? I'll just get rid of it and I'll drop the thing. We can't lose the clock, right? No one could cast like a curse spell on us who lose the clock. That would be stupid. Severely doubt that. One or two more, I will do it. More like two. Alright, let's see if we can cast this spell. I want identification. On this two-hander that I gave Droba. Two-handed sword, melee weapon, 20 damage, warrior paladin. It's not magic, it's just a two-handed sword. Understood. So it's 20, you say? But Fire Basher does 15. But this is not a magic weapon. So some things will not be injured by it. I'm gonna have to keep him down at 15, unfortunately. What about Ice Spider? I'm ready on him. Damage 20. So since he can't even use this yet, give Ice Spider to Droba and then yeah, he'll have the hand-me-down of the Fire Basher. When I've gotten his parry up to a significant amount, because he gets injured way too quickly in battle, and he misses a lot, so better off to give Drebin the more powerful weapon, at least for now. So, can you hold this too, even though you're holding the other thing? No. Seem to be stuck here, okay. There we go. She can do that. So then, Drebin can give Ice Spider over. Two Raider, we're just gonna sell that. So Ice Spider is the 20 damage one. Yeah. So damage 15. 20. And this one's 15, obviously. Okay. So you'll hold on to that until you stop getting bashed around so much. And then at least he can cast Fireball with it. So I want to sell the clock, the two-handed sword, the knife. It's probably going to be like 2 gold or something. The studded leather. I still want to identify the iron ring. By the time he can use something, we might find something better, another sword better than Fire Basher anyway. But it's good to have an inventory just to cast Fireball. If nothing else, we'll hold out to it for that. Iron ring, Sateen actually has it. Oh, and I do want to look at this crossbow. I'm assuming it's just a regular crossbow. But do we really want to assume that? And this is just stuff, alright. Alright, so let's see. Hope this isn't boring for you guys. I love identifying items. It's freaking awesome. Let's, like, see what kind of goodies we have. Yay! Iron ring! It's a ring! Shield of one. Okay. One figure. Anyone can use it. Okay, increases your shield by one. So might as well have a fighter use that. So they get hurt less often. And then the fighter, we find better rings with the fighters, they'll pass it down to other people. That kind of thing. No, one of us has a ring. I think I do. That's an iron... That's the same thing, right? Iron ring? But I never get hit because I'm on the back. So I should... We should actually give them both to Drebin. Yeah, these are going to Drebin. The often hit. Alright, so we know it's her... Can I transfer it? No, I have to take it off first. Maybe this will help. Cool. So his shield is now 24. Better than Drobaneer. I think it was always better than Drobaneer, it's just he has nowhere near as many hit points as Drobaneer does. So, he still gets whacked down. So we want to also cast... Check the crossbow. Identifications. It worked. 20 damage. Oh. Only usable by warrior, paladin, or monk. We're not gonna have a monk. I think you can find a monk somewhere, but we're not gonna have a monk. I'm pretty happy with the characters we have right now. I'm pretty sure this is gonna be till end game here. I've invested a lot into them, so. One-handed and 20 damage. I wonder if we can easily switch a weapon. It's a good thing they don't have separate range attacks and, you know, stuff like that. So, that's silly though. A crossbow only usable by those three, whereas the short bow thief can also use. Disappointing. Alright, so I guess we'll give it to Drebin. And we have four crossbow bolts, so maybe we can buy some more crossbow bolts and just have him hold on to that. When he gets two damage, we'll back him off and just use the crossbow. That'd be a good idea. Yeah, I like that idea. Because he's not going to be able to carry crap because he has all this stuff now. All of them. I think one person has another. There's a we're going to have to buy torches too. For some reason, I thought we found five of those. Alright, maybe not. They can actually carry a little bit more. So he's carrying Fire Basher, Staff of Resurrection, Crossbow with Bolts. And the Wand of Light. So who else can use that? Anyone can use that. Should I just hold on to that then? So you can carry more. Drebin, we're gonna hold on to that. So he can carry more of these bolts. I wonder how much he'll be able to carry. Wand of Light, alright. Give it to Drebin. There we go. Anything else before we're done here? He's got Staff of Direction. She's the only one who can use it. Because I'm not going to have a ranger or a monk, so gray wizard only. Magic compass. I wonder if we even need that, if it's just going to do the same, have the same effect as this. Then we don't need it. Okay. We're good. Off screen, I'm going to have her camp and level up to full. Is there anything else we need to do other than just sell some things? Yeah, I'll be back. I'll show you guys me selling some stuff. Why not? Okay, the general store. Bloop. So we already have well over 3,000. I gave the stuff to Silk. Let's just select him then. Alright, can we sell that? The clock, 95, you got it. 200 sword, ooh, 1533 gold, yes. And the studded leather, 115. He will not buy the signet ring or the villa key. He will buy the knife, For 18 gold, that's more than I thought. Alright. So now we have over 5,000 gold again. That is awesome. Now I could go to the Tower of the Black Wizards, but we'll have not much left. And what I want to do at this point is get some more sling stones and some more torches. Actually, yeah, it's gonna make it into one big pile. Torches. So that's 200 gold right there. And so I'm gonna give her 20. And Drebin the other 20. How is Drobinir doing? He can't carry too much more. I wanted to see if he can carry some more rocks for Trasrek. And we'll see. How much does he have? Hold up. Not about another 20 rocks. It'll give him an even 99. Well, not even 99, but a full stack of 99. And then, yeah, that's where we were. That's where we were at. So, another 20 rocks. That must have been how much Trasrek used, is 20. If not, someone else will carry it. Good. So he is, yeah, close to being overweight. So, how's Silk doing on arrows? Oh, I wanted to see if that guy had... He's pretty good with arrows. Arrows are in... Jewel. I want to see if they sell crossbow bolts in here. We might have to go to Gemstone for that. Guys, remember Gemstone? Way back when? That's where we found Drebin, I think. Yeah. No, that's what I want to buy. Pretty much nothing useful here. So at some point, I guess we'll need this for something. No, I do not want to give him items that are important to me. As in a lot of items, as in 5,220 or so items. Or gold pieces. That's what I want to do. You can't carry very many. I wonder how heavy these things are. Crossbow bolts. 300 grams. I'm not really sure how much that is. 300 grams. Let me just see. Okay, they're heavier than rocks, so we're not going to be able to carry too many of those things. So I believe where we're going now is back to the gemstone lady, because she was telling us something about mushrooms. She was looking for mushrooms. She can do something with mushrooms. Something having to do with mushrooms. Pretty sure. So we're going to head back there next episode. And then after that, I mean, we also have more of her... Her cave. The Sprite Cave, I believe it's called? Sprite Tunnel? Sprite Cave? Something like that? There's a key to get past it, so if we help her in her quest, or maybe we give her these mushrooms, something, she will give us the key to advance further into... down her the Sprite Cave, and so we'll go adventuring in there and see what good things are in there. There's also a chest we haven't been able to get at in there, I'm pretty sure. It just kills us. So, I'm sure Silk still can't disarm the trap, but so we're not going to go for that. Not yet, anyway. We need lockpicks. He needs to... he needs to increase his skill in picklocking and removing traps and such like that. So, well, maybe if we get blasted by it, maybe we'll have enough hit points to where we don't all die, and then we can just rest at an inn if whatever's in there is important enough or worth it. Yeah. So, yeah, I'm pretty happy right now. We defeated the big baddie. We all leveled up. We got a bunch of new items. We're rich again, relatively speaking, and we're about to head out to a new location, maybe hopefully finish that up. So thanks so much for watching, guys. See you in the next episode, and always seek adventure.